Hello everyone, this is Shilpa B, Assistant Professor of Department of ISC, Canberra Engineering College. So I am teaching you file structure concept. So let us go for the next concept, cost of disk axis. We have already seen all these things, that is seek time, rotational delay and transfer delay. While I describe sector organization, I have use the term of seek time, rotational delay and transfer time. So let us see how exactly it is a disadvantage of disk organization and how we can overcome this. Okay, so cost of disk axis, these three things which will cost you the cost for disk axis. First let us go for the seek time. So seek time is nothing but it is the time required to move the axis arm to the correct cylinder. As we have already seen the sector organization. Now let me tell you, if this is your track and you have different several sectors over here. Okay. Now you have a read write head which is reading. This is the read write head, and this read write head is positioned in the arm, right? You have arm which will move forward and backward, right? Now you have one more, say you have one more track over here, you have different several sectors over this. Okay, now what is the thing is, now I am reading the data from this particular sector, say this sector. Now I want to read from the next sector. Next sector is this. I want to read the data from this. Now what I need to do, I need to move this arm this way so that my read write head will come this way and it will read the next particular sector. So I need to move my axis arm to the correct cylinder in order to read the next particular data. Okay, so that time moving this arm to the correct cylinder, that time we call it as seek time. The amount of time spent during a disk axis, it depends on how far the arm has to move. Say if it is, now you are in this particular cylinder, you are reading this. Now it is in the next cylinder, then the time consuming will be less. But if you have number of tracks here, if you have number of tracks and you are reading from the innermost disk initially, and now you want to read the sector, this particular sector, now the time consuming is more, right? So it depends on how far the arm has to move, right? So the system designer often go to minimize number of seeks or seeking so that time consuming will be less. That is one of the cost. So average seek time is nothing but we usually try to determine average seek time that is required for the particular operation. So for hard disk, the average seek time is less than 10 millisecond, and for high performance disk it is less than 7.5 millisecond. Okay, so that we need to remember, average seek time. Usually seek time we calculate the average seek time. Now rotational delay, what exactly the rotational delay is? It is the time it takes for the disk to rotate. So the sector we want is under the read write head. Okay, so as I told, in our sector organization we had different sectors over here, and you have one sector, one where your read write head is pointing to. Now if you want now you are transferring the data from sector 1, so transfer delay occurs. By that time, the disk will rotate some way, and your read-write head might be now reading somewhere, which is here you have 4, sector 4. So your read-write head will read the data from sector 4. Now I want to read the data from sector 2, right? So to do this, I want to rotate my disk once again in order to read the sector 2. So that time we can call it as, that delay we can call it as rotational delay. It is the time it takes for the disk to rotate, so the sector we want is under read-write head. Usually for hard disk, usually rotate at about 500 rotational per minute RPM. That is one rotation per 12 milliseconds. Okay. So for floppy disk, it is 360 RPM, one rotation per 83.3 milliseconds. If you consider this and this floppy disk, this rotational delay is very big if you compare hard disk and floppy disk. Average rotational delay is the time for the disk to rotate 180 degree. Usually we calculate average rotational delay, so that is nothing but the time for the disk to rotate 180 degree. Now, what do you mean by transfer time? That is the next cost you have. So transfer time is nothing but, now we are reading some data which was under the read-write head. It needs to be transferred to the main memory. We call it as transfer time. Okay, time which needs to transfer the data from disk to main memory, we call it as transfer time. So it can be written as, transfer time is nothing but number of bytes transferred divided by number of bytes on track into rotation time. That is nothing but the transfer time. If drive is sectored, transfer time for one sector, it depends on the number of sectors on the tracks. If number of sectors are more, transfer time will be more. Now, what do you mean by disk bottleneck or disk bound? The network and the computer CPU have to wait for some time for the disk to transmit the data. Obviously, you will be having some amount of data which needs to be transmitted to the main memory. But if your operating system is doing some other job, then you need to wait for some time in order to transmit the data. A number of techniques that are used to solve this problem is, one is multi-programming, one more is striping. So multi-programming is nothing but CPU works on other jobs while waiting for the data to arrive. So you will be having different programs which will run. So CPU, it will work on the other job when you are waiting for the data to be arrived. That is called as multi-programming. What is striping? Splitting the part of a file on several different drives, then letting the separate drives deliver parts of the file to the network simultaneously. Now you might be heard of the parallel programming, that which will reduce the waiting time, or I can call which will reduce the disk bound. So this is about the today's topic. Let us wind up and we'll discuss in the next session. Thank you.